And we're back. Hi, this is Stu Miniman with Wikibon.org, here with SiliconANGLE TV's live continuous coverage from HP Discover here in Las Vegas. And joining me for this next segment is Rob Crawford, VP of Sales with QLogic. Rob, welcome back in theCUBE.
Thanks, Stu.
So Rob's actually a CUBE alum. He's been with QLogic just about a year, and one of the first things he did when he joined with QLogic is come on theCUBE last year at HP Discover.
I did. It was a brave experience to step up.
Great.
So for
those of you that aren't familiar with QLogic, they're one of these kind of core components that help, you know, infrastructure work. They're at the core of convergence, some of the building blocks for cloud, and even big data is using a lot of their technology. So, you know, everybody talks about like Intel inside. If you talk about convergence, QLogic's really one of the components driving that technology, and HP is a very strong partnership of QLogic. So, Rob, you know, tell us, you know, what's new with QLogic these days?
Well, it's been a busy year. We've got a lot of new technology, you know, that we've brought to market with HP. We've got, you know, a partnership with HP that's longstanding, 15 plus years that we've been working together. And, you know, I think if you look at, you know, the value of that partnership, we bring a lot of innovation into the HP product offering. It's probably our deepest technical relationship in terms of the partners that we work with. And so we've seen a lot of exciting things this year. I think the big, you know, announcement at the show this week was around the flat sand technology that was part of the three-par announcement this week. Very exciting technology, largely, you know, put in place to simplify sand infrastructure, make it a lot simpler to deploy a sand, to manage a sand, and to do it with less hardware and less complexity.
Okay, so obviously, you know, one of the challenges people talk about for sands in general is they tend to be a little bit complex, so can we just peel the onion a little bit when you talk flat sand and, you know, simplicity, you know, what does that mean? I got a little bit of a briefing, but if you can tee it up.
I mean, the basic idea is that, you know, if you look at QLogic technology, we're one of the few companies that has technology both on the switch side and on the host side, right, and also on the target side, right? So we kind of cover a variety of technology pieces within the infrastructure, and that allows us to do some creative things in terms of the way we can become part of a SAN infrastructure.
Okay.
And so a lot of what you see with the flat SAN technology is kind of taking the best of all those technologies and putting them together in a way that allows you to simplify some of the normally complex components in a SAN.
Okay, so if I can for a second,
sure.
I went to talk to some of your geeks over in the booth, and they whiteboarded this for me. So if you're familiar, you know, we've got a blade server. You know, HP blade server has the FlexFabric Virtual Connect switching component, which is QLogic technology. Typically, you're plugging that into an external switch for fan out and scalability, and then you've got the storage array on the other side. QLogic has adapters, you know, in a lot of the storage devices, and they also have the adapters inside the server. What this flat SAN technology is doing is we're saying, we don't need that external switch, because what we're going to do is on the internal switch, the virtual connect technology, what is currently NPIV mode, which basically means I can work with any external switch, means if I'm running NPIV mode, I can't plug a storage array directly into it. It's a different version of software that I need to have, you know, storage direct attach. And QLogic, now working with HP, has launched the ability to plug storage straight in. So it's just a different software mode for the switch, so we're not eliminating switching, it's just we're utilizing internal switching, and there's a good scalability story from the blade servers to the storage, so a lot of times I won't need to go buy that, you know, chassis, you know, very expensive, you know, switch. I can just scale it out in a more modular model using HP technology, leveraging QLogic components.
Yeah, I think it's
did I get it right?
I think you nailed it. So okay. I think that, you know, in this technology space, I think one of the things that's important is that this is not eliminating SAN. This is not an alternative to SAN. This is really just a matter of simplifying and reducing some of the complexity that makes SAN less accessible to you know, customers that don't have extensive experience or don't have the extensive teams to deploy it and don't want the complexity.
It really extends the blade server and converged infrastructure messaging, reducing cabling, simplicity, still a fiber channel switched environment. So, you know, storage admins don't have to worry about this is something different. It's just going to be, you know, plug and go, all the stuff that they love and everything.
In my mind, this is extending the viability of SANs, right? So I think there's SAN and fiber channel storage is obviously a very central part of our business.
So let's talk fiber channel. I mean,
sure.
You know, for a second, you know, what's the state of the industry on fiber channel from QLogic's perspective?
Well, I mean, this is a time when fiber channel is you know, in an exciting transition, right? So 16 gig technology is now you know, coming into the market. You've got, you know, transitions that are happening as part of that. I think one of the things that we're wanting to make sure we stay on top of is just when that transition's going to happen in the market. We'll make sure our technologies are relevant. A lot of what we're doing, technology-wise, is converging our technology to support multi-protocol. If you look at our switching technology, if you look at our adapter technology, if you look at our technology as it applies on the host side, one of the great things that we've announced and we've been promoting a lot in the industry is a common multi-protocol architecture that allows you to have flexibility in terms of how you use storage in a networked environment.
Yeah, no, I mean, so, you know, I've been pretty vocal about, it's not about fiber channel or Ethernet, it's those two protocols are actually coming together. QLogic with HP actually had the first solution on that with the Flex Fabric Virtual Connect, which has been out over 2 years now. Yep. Cisco has this kind of technology, Juniper is doing some things, but, you know, QLogic's really been the leader in bringing that in from the adopter side and the switch side now when the 16 gig product hits the market.
Yep.
So, you know, we're talking about when adoption happens, I think that the piece that is kind of missing from the puzzle right now is the storage technology. And while I understand you can't, you know, pre-announce any OEMs, just, you know, broad strokes, you know, is that a late this year? You know, when do we expect to see 16 gig end-to-end?
Yeah, I think, you know, the end-to-end piece, is, there's a lot of dependencies on when this actually goes end-to-end. I think one of the biggest components that dictates when, you know, a faster speed makes sense is on the target side, and when the target arrays start to, you know, offer 16 gig technology in terms of how they participate in the SAN. So I think what we're seeing, you know, ballpark, you know, I think towards the end of this calendar year, we'll start to see some things. I think, you know, mainstay, the big guys probably a little further out even still. And, you know, I think one of the things that, you know, we're actively participating on a lot of that business today with those partners. And I think as those technologies come to market, you'll be hearing a lot more about it.
Yes, right, so the translation on that is we expect QLogic to have design wins. They've got lots of design wins on the storage arrays, and with 16 gig fiber channel, PMC Sierra has exited the market, so that has left a transition in the fiber channel market where QLogic's there and Emulex have been fighting for those OEM design wins. Yep. Where on the storage, it's really sticky.
Yep.
You know, so maybe talk on the server side for a bit, because one of the challenges for companies like QLogic, we talked about this with Intel, we talked about this with Broadcom this week, is the adapter market, when we go to 10 gig, tends to be what they call the FlexLAM technology. So all the server guys are qualifying everyone. So if you want QLogic, you can buy it, you know, HP, Dell, IBM, but you can also take Emulex, or you can take Intel or Broadcom, even Brocade and Mellanox are getting into the mix there.
Yep.
So, you know, how does QLogic differentiate themselves in the marketplace and get those customers to choose?
Well, the 10 gig market's interesting, right? And you talk about the FlexLAM technology. Really, I think what has proven out is that level of flexibility is really important in this market. So the idea that that customers are going to have preference in terms of the 10 gig fabric that they deploy and how they put that together is something that the our partners are embracing. So I think part of what is important is to figure out, you know, when does it make sense to have QLogic as a selection? What are the places where we really differentiate and add value? And I think, you know, We look at it as a broad deployment, but the key pieces that we think where we're differentiated and offer some really compelling you know, offerings in that space. Virtualization's a big one. The ability to do partitioning, you know, at a NIC level and support a virtualized environment with quality of service as part of how you implement 10 gig Ethernet, we see as being a big attractor. So virtualized
You had a term for that, I believe. It was like...
So NIC partitioning or NPAR refer to. And it allows you to virtualize the NIC layer.
Yep.
and assign quality of service for different app loads, really applicable in a virtualized environment. Because I might have critical applications and less critical applications running on a single virtualized server.
Right.
So what you can do is assign specific workload quality of service through the NIC level out into the fabric. So it's a great differentiator. It's something we've seen, you know, very popular with folks that are deploying virtualized environments today. The second piece that's, you know, that's always going to be kind of, you know, central to our business is storage. If you're, you know, 10 gig Ethernet's a phenomenal technology. One of the great things it does is it opens up the pipe where you can have real converged infrastructure. Like, can you start, you know, using it as part of my storage infrastructure? As part of that, you know, FCOE and the support of, you know, protocols that are popular in the storage realm is something that we've always been known for. clearly a place where we have a differentiated offering and think we add a lot of value.
Yeah, and not just SVE, but iSCSI,
sure.
QLogic has a long history on iSCSI.
We do.
Deep with the storage people, you know, really a trusted stack.
Yep.
Something I know when I talk to enterprises, it's any new protocol is they like, but I've tested my entire application stack with
right.
these drivers, and QLogic gives a kind of a common look and feel across, you know, lots of different offerings.
And it's one of the things that we see that's interesting, right? So in the fiber channel market, we have a share leadership position that's pretty well documented. You know, vast majority of customers that are running fiber channel, you know, prefer QLogic technology. We've built up that share position based on great solutions in market. And one of the things you worry about is when you go into a, you know, 10 gig Ethernet world, that share preference starts to have less relevance. I think one of the things that's interesting is if you look at the share position in our FCOE products, it maps very closely to the share position we have with our fiber channel products. So it's a good indicator that folks that are moving into an FCOE environment, converged environment, you know, one way that they, you know, maintain comfort and make sure they have confidence in the reliability of the stack that they're using is to use the same stack in both places. And that obviously QLogic has a good solution there.
Great, so you know, we dug pretty deep on how QLogic fits into the convergence story. Obviously cloud, you know, big discussion here. HP has lots of different offerings. Does QLogic have an angle into the cloud?
We do. I mean, the cloud's an interesting, there's different ways you can look at it, right? You know, one of the things that we see is, you know, obviously the large cloud infrastructure providers are a big consumer of technology. We, you know, we work hard to make sure that our offerings stay relevant with them. A lot of what you see right now in those big cloud providers is the 10 gig Ethernet is a very relevant technology for how they're, you know, deploying their environments today. Great offering in that space. Also interesting that you see, you know, movement, you know, on the end user side, right? So as end users start to look at cloud infrastructure as being part of their infrastructure, all of the things that we do to connect things together, really we're an IO-centric company. And as storage is a play, both at the end user level and at the cloud provider level, all the IO that makes that come together and work is something we're very focused on from a technology perspective. So we see that as being, you know, really a great opportunity for us because, you know, cloud environments, more than anything, you need flexibility. So flexibility of a converged infrastructure, but you also need people that understand multi-protocol, that can move data between different types of environments. And as people build out their cloud environments, sometimes that's with public cloud, sometimes it's with private cloud, sometimes it's co-located. You've got a lot of different options, and having flexibility on the infrastructure is really what makes it happen.
All right, so Rob, the final question that I have for you is, you know, you're a sales guy.
I am.
So, can you give, you know, what's your take on kind of just the, you know, conditions in the marketplace today, you know, for storage and overall for networking?
Yeah, I mean, this is one of those interesting times in the market right now. You know, the Romley server launches was a big thing, and as we, you know, see that business ramp and as IT organizations start to look at transitions of their server architecture, you know, anytime that's going on, that creates opportunities for us. A lot of our business is tied to servers. When servers are being sold, we attach to those servers. So this is one of those transitions in the server cycle that are always exciting, and you try to figure out how quickly that transition happens, you know, what is the, as people are moving into new environments, what do the new environments look more like? I think one of the things that we see a lot with the Romley servers is that they're able to scale much larger in terms of virtual machines. VM environments tend to be very, you know, perform very well in the new Romley servers. Anytime you've got a lot of virtual machines on a server, IO becomes a critical part of the configuration. And so we see our participation on the IO side of that, both, you know, from a storage perspective, but also more broadly as you put in 10 gig Ethernet technology. Our participation in that part of the market is going to be really critical. So, you know, we see that transition as helping us, and we see a lot of good, you know, momentum in the business because of that. I think on the storage side, you see a lot of things happening as well, right? So you kind of, if you plot out the different parts of the market where things are changing, between storage, networking, and servers, we're in the midst of a lot of moving parts right now. And I think anytime that's happening, flexibility is what makes it all happen. It's you know, I don't have to move everything at one time. I've got flexibility in my infrastructure. That's really a place where QLogic brings a lot of value. So, you know, bringing storage together with networking, with servers, is really what we're all about.
Great, so Rob Crawford, VP of sales for QLogic, exciting times in the networking convergence space. Congrats on your 1 year anniversary.
Thank you.
With QLogic. Thanks so much for coming back and sharing with us.
Good, I hope to be back here again a year from now.
Sounds great, and or VM World, we might catch you up.
There you go, that'd be
great. So, always good to see you.
Good.
And, this is Stu Miniman with Wikibon. We will be right back with our live continuous coverage right after this brief break.